this presentation, we're going to be talking about social media. I know you all here just to hear you speak. We want to fill in your FYE textbooks, whichever way the case may be. But let's start off with, I guess, a quick question. Who here uses social media? Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Vine, yeah, Vine's a good one. What else? YouTube, very good. Tumblr, Pinterest. Did I miss any? Some people consider the Snapchat. Having a lot of back and forth here, I'm not going to Snapchat, but several others that you really can count, but I want everyone to know that at least those big ones, that's like the important ones, I guess, the ones that are very popular. Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Google Plus. Anybody use Google Plus in here? There's like six people in the world. I'm one of them. Instagram, Snapchat, Vine, just about those top words, a good one. The reason I want to go over this part is I was reading a study that Pew did about how teenagers and young adults use the internet, and they say 90%, 95%, something like that, admit to using social media, but only 20% of people consider Twitter to be social media. So I was really interested to see if everyone, I mean, Facebook's the universal one, but I was interested to see what everyone else said. That's what you said, what we use. Who uses more than one of these? Google Plus is an elimination for what I think is most popular. But do anybody of you have a Facebook account? Almost everybody, okay? Leave your hand up if you have a Twitter account. Still, solid majority. YouTube. A little bit more on Twitter, a little more on the Facebook levels. Instagram. More than Twitter on each of them, first, okay? Fine. I had some people like, I've got an account. I guess a different question, but who actually uses their account? What are you creating right now? Who uses Snapchat? Okay. And we gathered only about two or three of you use Google Plus. Okay, that's interesting. Now, do you all have favorites? Which favorite? Is what, Tumblr? Who would say Tumblr is their favorite? One, okay. Facebook. The popularity of Facebook has like taken a nosedive over the last two or three years. Twitter? Okay. And you see kind of a fall of the ideas of how people are gone from Facebook as well. What about Instagram? I think most people on Instagram never like sharing pictures, right? Okay. And everyone likes the filters. Okay, so we've kind of established what social media is, and we've kind of touched on why we use it. Some people use it to keep in touch with friends, former classmates, family. Some people use it to show everyone a picture of their morning cup of coffee. Some people use it to share news stories and make sure you know they're smarter than you are. They'll try to convince you of that. Some people use it to let their friend know that they're very angry at them for doing them wrong. So we've got this environment that's basically a public space, but we all use it a little differently, and we judge people based on how they use it, right? Who has judged a friend or someone because of how they use social media? I expect to see every hand up. Have you ever judged anybody? I'm impressed. Okay. So, here's something else that's interesting. On that Pew survey I was mentioning, 59% of teenagers said that they deleted or edited something that they've posted online. And I'm going to guess that number is a little low. Do I ask who has deleted something that they posted at some point? Okay, I have. I've done it. YouTube's my rates in the middle of a football or hockey game. And I realize after about 20 of them, nobody cared. 45% have removed their name from a tag or a photo. Who's had a friend post a photo of you that you were not pleased with? car somewhere, they can share a picture of you, somewhat without a kind of your own control on it. And then another 19% said, I guess this is saying that they did not remove anything that they had wished that they had. And so it's important to realize social media is two things. It is a public place, and it is a permanent place. Because even when you delete those tweets, those Facebook posts, somebody else may have saved it. It can exist somewhere on the internet. And so it's very important to take a quick moment before you push the submit, the post button, the tweet button, and say, wait a minute. Tomorrow, I'm not going to be happy with this. Or, in the case of especially photos, 5 years from now, am I going to want this when my boss, future boss, goes looking at my social media accounts? So take a good long breath and think about what you're posting before you do so. Now, I got heard from some of the students that there was really a Twitter you thought that was a private space. You've got to understand these are public domains. Things that I've seen posted on Twitter. I sound like Old Man Perkins here for a second, but I'll be like, well, I was just going to try to steal a couple of tweets from I follow with the Darton Facebook account and Twitter account. I actually couldn't find one that had language appropriate for a YouTube video. It makes me want to remind people this is a public place, which when you put something up on Twitter, it is no different than if you went and stood out by the flagpole in the fountain. And just yelled it across the campus. Because anybody can find those things. They can search. The friends of friends can see things. So just be aware that I think we like to think of the internet as private. It's our account. We select who follows us or who's our friend and who we follow. But it's still very much a public place because there are so many connections. And so even if you intend it for something to be private, to be personal, someone else is going to find a way to find it and see it. What they also know who your friends are. We've talked about Facebook. You can be tagged in a photo and have a friend say that you are hanging out at Locos when your instructor clearly knows it's time for class. I have seen people who are in my class tweet, man, this guy's really boring. The truth may hurt sometimes, but do you really want your teacher to see that you posted that while you were in class? What's that? Because they followed me on Twitter and I followed them back on. They didn't think the process through all the way. And there's an interesting story at CNN right just last week, and I saw this. When you go to apply for a loan, there are some companies that are searching who your friends are on Facebook and are trying to determine if you are a reliable and trustworthy lender. So if you have a friend on Facebook who hasn't made all their payments on time to this company, they may actually hold that against you a little bit and you may not get as good of an interest rate. If these companies are doing that, I promise you an employer is doing that. So if you have a top secret, fully private Facebook account, if they can find one of your friends, they may make some judgments about you based on your friends. But I might not be right. We don't have a friend that is unwilling and like hanging around with us, right? Have to be aware what they do is public. It does reflect upon you to some degree. So this is where it starts getting tricky. It's not just I'm hanging out with my friends now. Now it is people get to watch how I behave. Again, we're going back to being a public place, and employers are making judgments about you based on what you're posting, and I would imagine what your friends are posting. But this can be a good thing. You can make social media work for you. You can use this to build your own credibility, to make you look like the best person that could be hired. If you start working on it, man, you can start building your own online resume. You can connect with people who work in a field that you want to go into. You can share stories about your field on Twitter or on Facebook and show that you're reading, that you're engaged, that you're becoming an expert in that field long before you ever even go to apply for a job. You can build a network of people you follow, because you never know one day that person you follow who you know is a nurse posts, shares, retweets a job posting from their company, their hospital, on Twitter? Has anybody created a list before on Twitter? Does anybody know what I'm talking about? No? Well, let me show you. My job history, I used to work in a news station. I went to college in Syracuse. I went to my master's degree at the University of Memphis. I work at a college now, and I have friends who have branched out into different jobs. I have connections from college to colleges, from television, from public relations, from social media, who are academics in higher ed. It's a lot of people to keep up with. And so what Twitter lets me do, and I'm going to skip out of my PowerPoint here, Twitter lets me create lists where I can create separate news feeds just for subject areas that I care about. So I've got one here making headlines. This is for journalists and journalism people that I follow. And then I have one for PR people. And so if I click on college PR, my feed that I see now will be just related to that topic. If I went back to my list, I could then click on the journalism one if I could follow people just on that. This could be a great way to separate your friends from your quote unquote professional lives. And it's a great way to kind of help make sure you don't lose those people in the feed. Because if you go 8 hours without logging on Twitter, you've missed a ton of information. But if you break these people into lists, you can keep up with that a little bit better. Let's see what we've got. So again, this is creating lists. Use hashtags. Everyone knows what a hashtag is, right? We've got that. Follow people who you think might be influential, and you're starting to kind of build yourself as a professional. Employers will search your accounts. I can almost promise you. 39% of employers check social media, and that's up 10% from the year before, and this is about a year old. It could be up to 50% by now. 43% of those have found information that cost the candidate their job. So they saw something on social media that made them choose not to hire that person. I think I've got some bragging up right here. On the other hand, this can be good. 19% have said they found information that made it more likely for them to hire a person. And so this is why I'm talking about using it to be proactive. Spend a little bit of time a day working towards what your future is going to be. The top three reasons to convey a professional image, good feel for the person's personality, and they saw some creativity. So you don't even have to be an expert. They're not asking the truth to it. You already know what this job's going to be. They just want to know that you've got a personality that's going to fit in with their office. If you use SMH, or you complain about every line you've ever been in, or every color in front of you, if every other tweet you have or every other Facebook post is a complaint, it's not going to be the greatest image of yourself, right? If all I see is a complaint, if you were interviewing a friend and you would check, the person doesn't really ever complain, he complains about their own friends all the time. You're going to tell them that much. I think about it twice. Depends on if they have a better corner or artistical tickets or anything. So use this to be a tool for you to be, I guess, an audition for you to impress a future employer. So what can you do now? Search for themselves on the internet. Help people. If you haven't, it's a good idea. Take a few minutes, do a little Google search, search your name. You might go through some other people who have your name. It took me a page or two to find myself. But that's the first step. That's what an employer is going to do when they start considering you. They're going to search for you on Google, on Facebook posts, Twitter posts, tweets, I'm sorry, pictures. Those will all show up there. There's things that show your creativity, show your experience, show your thinking about your future. Be careful with those privacy settings. One, I'm pretty sure the Facebook ones change like every other week, right? So keeping up with that's a full-time job, so it might be easier with Facebook just to forget it and not post anything that you wouldn't want to be public. I'm saying for your tweets, even if you try to protect your tweets, sometimes those are searchable. People can just search for a couple words and find you. And I always ask, general rule, would I want the entire world to see this before you post? And one question I didn't ask you here has two accounts on one. service. So you say, we have two Facebook accounts, like one for their family to see, one for their friends to see. This was a popular thing for a while until people realized that you could search both and find them. And some people try to do that. It may help you a little bit if you create kind of, here's where my friends are. If you think there's too much for you to undo on Facebook, maybe you start creating a second account. You kind of work your way there and start fading out the other one so that that can become your new, I guess, professional account, we'll call it. But those are just some things that you can do to try to, I guess, put your best foot forward on the internet. Any questions? Twitter @DartonCollege. We're on Twitter @DartonCollege. You can use the hashtag #MyDartonState. We're also on Pinterest.